Check that out, Mike.
What we got?
We're with Joe and Wally in Central Washington, picking through Joe's dad's body shop that he packed floor to ceiling with car parts, motorcycle parts, and anything else he could find.
This is great.
Yeah, you don't find a lot of this old stuff here.
This is awesome.
Smashed it up.
It's dark and it's packed full.
Here you go, check this out. A little dual power.
This is just exactly the kind of place I like to be in.
Yeah, he kept a little bit of everything, didn't he? There's a lot of rims up there.
All of this stuff was junk. It was going to scrap. But guys like Joe's dad, the pickers, the scrappers, the body men, had that crystal ball. And they knew someday all of us were gonna appreciate this even more.
Well, Joe, I found the grill for the 34 Ford. There it is right there.
You guys got a 34 Ford?
The wing model?
Yep. Yeah. I'm not sure what that car is, a 33 or a 34 Outback.
Wally had my attention as soon as he said they had a 33 or a 34 Ford.
Got it. Good. Got it. Woo! Got it. Got it. Got it.
What do you got exactly? Is it a rolling chassis?
Yeah, a set of frame rails, rear end, front axle, body, doors.
32, 33, 34, these cars are highly sought after, but for some reason, the 33 seems like the hardest one to find.
Look at that.
Ooh.
Oh, Frank, look at that tree coming right up on it.
It's been sitting there a while, hasn't it?
Up against the tree is a 1933 five-window coupe. Now, 32 was an epic year for Ford. The first V8, the first year body style, I mean, they nailed that. But in 33, they took it to the next level. It was more aerodynamic, it was more streamlined, the grille was swooping, the hood louvers were curved.
Pretty solid piece.
You can look at the dash. On a 33, it's a 1 year only dash.
Such a desirable car, they completely remake these bodies.
The 32 is beautiful, but the 33 is the older, sexier sister.
So what you've got is you've got a body, you've got a frame, the rear end.
So you got the block.
The dash is gone. But
yeah, there's a dash in the back room.
Is there?
Yeah, a red one hanging against the back wall over there.
It's a good candidate for restoration.
This is the way I want to find them. No paint, you can see what you're dealing with. There's no Bondo in this thing. I mean, this is real deal Henry Ford steel.
I'm just looking at the bottom of this door. It looks like it's rotted, it looks like. The bottom of that door on the right is worse than this one.
This car is in great shape considering where it's lived all of these years. It's solid. Yes, it has rust on it, but it doesn't have a lot of rot. There's a difference between rust and rot. Rot is beyond rust, where you can just poke your finger through it and there's large holes. This is just surface rust with some of the old paint color coming through.
Well, where are you guys at? Have you talked to anybody in your family about wanting to sell this or where you're at with selling it?
Oh, it's all gonna be sold. We just, don't know where to start.
What would you feel comfortable selling it at?
I think if somebody came right up and offered you 14 for it, he'd probably take it.
Yeah, with the things that we mentioned that go with it.
Yeah.
How nice is the dash?
It's complete, it's got the instrument panel. It's hanging right on the back wall in the shop when we were in there.
$14,000 is a lot of money, but he says he's got the dash, he's got the grill. Those are the things that are gonna add up that really make this car have value. That's where the money comes in.
What do you think?
So I'm looking at the situation, I'm thinking, if we come to a deal, how are we gonna get this out of here? Because there's a tree growing up on its side. And I want to free this car from where it's embedded so the shipper doesn't have any problems when he comes to pick it up.
There's a lot of local car builders here that have been bugging me to sell stuff.
It's like you just kind of, when you buy something like this, you just got to jump off.
Yeah, because then, then you got to jump off a lot more times.
And you better be doing more than dog paddling.
14?
We're doing it. I'm gonna do it.
All right.
I'm doing this.
To find a 33 Ford five-window coupe sitting next to a tree, that's picking folklore. So I tell Joe and Wally, if you know a tow truck driver, get him over here because we're gonna start digging this thing out. This is the kind of challenge that we live for.
All right, Frank.
Okay, watch out.
Try pulling back straight back. Whoa, okay, wait. You're hitting a firewall up here.
So it's a little bit touch and go, trying to get this thing out. You have to get the front wheels past that stump because we're trying to preserve the car on the left side of it. Push it forward. We got to push it forward so we can straighten the wheels.
Whoa.
That's the biggie. And then while you're trying to do that, the back end is shifting, and it's going up against the other cars right next to it. And the last thing we want to do is mess up this body, because that's the money.
So you got to
go straight back. You can't pick. You got to go straight back, not up and back, straight back. You know, every time you thought you had the front of it around the edge of the tree to pull it straight, the car was going really close to the next one.
You're going to scrape that 57 one.
So we were really trying to be respectful, but aggressive.
There we go.
I think it's going.
Yep, all the wheels are rolling on it. Yeah. That's amazing.
It's looking better now.
Woo!
Looking good.
All right, Dan, we got it out.
Honored to own it. There's a lot of different ways to go at this car. If you want to make the car perfect, you can do that. But the guy that wants to honor it the way it is, just run it without the fenders, Bonneville style, man, just going down the road, no hood, put a big flatty in there, dual power, is appreciating it even more. It was cool. It was one of those days that I'll never forget, because you never find a 33 Ford like that. That's what I want on my gravestone, man. Here lies a guy that cut a 33 Ford five-window coupe from a tree.
Sweet picket!
Down the road they go.
It's like a day-to-day treasure hunt. I'm out there looking for rusty gold. I'm looking for the unusual and impossible.
It's back roads, it's dumpster diving, it's flea markets, it's people's homes.